I like my coffee like I like my men, behind bars. I got the call around midnight. 3 murdered, no witnesses. The only thing found at the crime scene? A rubber chicken. This murder was under wraps, and I had night moves. The missing person was a devil in a blue dress, and I love trouble. 8 million ways to die, but only one way to solve this case. Kiss, kiss, bang, bang, honey. He said a long goodbye to his Maltese Falcon, but I had an angel heart. Kiss me deadly before I take the big sleep. Murder may be sweet, but it's all lost in Chinatown. This is... A murder most foul.
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Hi, I'm calling because I need to find out what to do about all these geese. Outside, I need to know what to do about it.
I'm sorry. I kind of expecting a call right now.
One of them just pecked me in the fucking throat. Jesus.
Listen, is there any way that maybe you can call me back about whatever this is?
Yeah, I'd say there's about 15, 20, 21, maybe 22. It's a long shot of the, you know, that's about how many there are.
How about like 40 minutes? It's just there's a job that's.
Oh God, they're getting into.
I'm expecting
they're
an
getting
interview
into with... the vault. They're gonna steal all my little. Oh my God.
Oh. Can we start this one over?
I'm sorry to start. Hello, sir?
This is still... I like this scene. Hayden, just say something. We can cut to it. Just say anything.
I'm sorry. Do I have the right number? I was given this number and told to call if I had any issues. They said any issues. I should call this number.
Mm. Okay, no. I'm sorry, y'all.
Ice cream.
Yeah, it's good there.
Oh, ice cream. It's really good. I never had it before.
Can I try some?
Oh, go ahead, go ahead.
Thank you.
Pretty good, right?
Oh. Yeah, I kinda like that.
Oh, I'm gonna eat out of that more because I'm getting you like double dip.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I meant like get a bowl, not like get another spoon. No, don't get another spoon. I'm gonna have to wash these. Don't get another spoon.
No, this is good. It's actually pretty good.
Yeah. Don't get another spoon. Bowl.
Yeah, it's spoons, by the way.
Don't. Not the counter fork. That one's never been washed.
Whoa. You should try this. It's actually better.
You know, you guys, it's having awkward interactions with people is nothing new for me. It's been happening to me ever since way before COVID was a thing. It's just what I attract. You know, I guess you attract what you want. But I'm kind of a nerdy guy, so I guess that's part of it. You know, I meet like-minded people that are nerdy, and sometimes nerdy people are weird. I like Nintendo.
Yeah!
Yeah. I knew you'd cheer for that. I like Nintendo. I'm a big Nintendo nerd. You know, I'm 22 now, so I'm a bit old to play the games, but I'm just the right age to buy the toys. So that's what I like to do. I like to buy the merch for all this kind of stuff. And yeah, I love getting that stuff. And the other day, I'm fucking this up. A couple years ago, not the other day. Woo! We'll fix it in post. I was with my family at this flea market in San Antonio, where I'm from. There's this big, awesome flea market in San Antonio called Trader's Village. And for those that don't know, it's just this huge place. They have all these tents and booths set up to buy things. And in addition to that, they have carnival rides and even celebrity impersonators sometimes. It's the only place I know of with tents, a Ferris wheel, and Michael Jackson besides Neverland Ranch. So it's really cool. Really cool. And when we go here, I would always go straight for the old vintage gaming booths. I love looking at that stuff. And so this one day we were there, I went into this booth. I was looking at all these games that I'm not going to buy. And then I see on the shelf, there's this Donkey Kong plush. We all know the ape, Donkey Kong. Donkey Kong plush. And I'm like, oh man, it's not for sale, but like, I kind of want that like really bad. So last year, and I'm like, hey, you know, how much would that Donkey Kong be if I wanted to buy it? And then he goes, tell you what. Now, I didn't know this at the time, but I've since learned that if you offer to pay someone and they say, tell you what? If you're offering to give someone money, the best thing you could ever give someone, ever, and they have another idea, you should run. Get out of there. But I didn't know that. I was a naive little boy, 20 years old. And so I was like, fine, tell me this what that you're telling me. So he says, I will give you that Donkey Kong plush if you give me your best Donkey Kong impression. And I have never been asked to do that before. You know, I've practiced it a lot, like on my own in the mirror, but in public, like that's like weird. I was like, okay, you know what? Fine. I thought about it. I'm willing to demean myself for what I want. So I warmed up a bit, you know, clear my throat, you know, get ready, getting in the Donkey Kong mindset. And I kind of just let out like a, it was a Tim Allen grunt is what it was. And he kind of just stood there and we kind of just looked at each other. And my first thought was like, oh man, like, I'm not gonna get it. All right. I fucked up. Like, there's no way he's gonna give me this Donkey Kong now. That was the worst Donkey Kong impression anyone's ever done. But the good news is it wasn't, and I got my Donkey Kong. Yeah. No punchline, just a prize.
Making large amounts of wealth while doing the absolute bare minimum if I don't even understand how stocks work!
Jesse, over here, Jesse. It's me, Jesse, the glass elephant from your dream.
What brings you to this realm? How'd you get here? Fool, what portal? What dimension?
Your suffering at the hands of the stock market has granted me a physical form, Jesse, and I'm here to return the favor.
What? Yeah, right.
I will grant you any wish you desire, Jesse, be it fame wealth, love, power.
Go on.
All I require from you, Jesse, is a torch. Place your hands upon me, Jesse. And your dreams become reality. Touch me, O trash collector! May I grant your greatest desires and make them reality, be it fame, wealth, love!
I want trash!
You want...
Give me that good trash! Whoa! Yeah! Whoa! Ho ho ho! Yeah! Whoa! Oh yeah! What? Whoa! Whoa! Yeah! Yes! Yes! Trash! 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 What?
Yeah! Yeah! Hey, how's it going? Scary Harry coming at you with another sick top 10 list. You guys have been asking for this one for a while, so let's go ahead and get into it. Today, we're doing top 10 guys my mom has dated. Number 9, Terry. One time, I saw Terry get hit by a car, and when his legs were crushed, they just fell off like a lizard's tail and grew back as new legs. Number 8, Some Kind of Doctor. This guy was always listening to my heartbeat and hitting my little knees with little hammers. And one time he made me get in an MRI machine for a test, but he hid braces in my mouth. So when the magnets turned on, they ripped all of my teeth out in one clean motion. Number 7. Ted. Mobsby. Number 6. Dave. If I'm being honest, this has probably got to be the worst guy my mom has ever dated. One time on my birthday, he asked if he could borrow $15,000, and when I said no, he hit me 20 times in the head and then died instantly from a heart attack. Number 4. Barney. Stinson. Number 3. Number 2. Ryan Gosling. This guy fucking sucks. He talks too much about La La Land and always changed the Netflix passwords and said I couldn't use Netflix unless I used it to watch La La Land. And I said Netflix doesn't have La La Land, but he didn't care. One time I watched him kick a cat in the mouth. Number 1. The most important guy of them all. My dad. This guy fucking sucks.
Hello, children! Good morning! I am a dark wizard, and I don't know what I look like. Good morning! Now I need two people to draw me. Hayden Hotrick and Sam Bell. What do I see when I look in my looking glass? What do I see? Go, 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 make haste!
All right. Are we working together?
No, I don't know what I look like. I need two different versions of myself. Please, God, please, someone, show me what I look like now, please. Please. Oh, this is marvelous. Oh, and that's time. I like the one on my left with my hat. Oh, I forgot I had a hat and a little name tag. My name is DN. My name is D's Nuts. Oh, I feel so good. Thank you, Sam. Sam wins that one. All right, now please white out the screen. Thank you very much. Oh, but my little companion, my memory is horrible. So a little companion comes to the door. Now I need Jared and Luke team up to remind me what my companion looks like. Oh, wow. A circle. Oh, yes, it is circular in nature. It seems to be balancing a fortune cookie on its hand. Two fortune cookies, of course. Oh, yes. Now, I need to remember what I look like to scale on the side of it. Someone please draw me to scale on the side. I forget what I look like, too. Of course. Oh, well, that's right. Oh, of course. It is towering above me at a colossal height. It is eldritch and horror of the way. Oh, there we are. And off we go. Oh, look how happy we are. Thank you so much for reminding me what me and my buddy's little thing is. Now, Clayton, could you please type what his name is? Oh, I forget. I'm so stupid. Please type what his name is. I always forget. I always simply forget that his name is, what is it? Dumbober. Oh, I love him so much. Now I must run to the market. And I'm gonna see my favorite, my bestest friend. Now, can I get Ben and Hayden, please? Sam, both Haydens. And Clayton, please remind me all together, just work together. What does this person appear as? I forget. And she's gorgeous. The one thing I remember is that she is gorgeous. She's beautiful. I think I would love to marry her someday. Oh, man. Oh, wow. Oh, it's all coming back to me. She's like a candle. She seems to be melting when you see her. Oh, she's so hot. Oh, fuck. She's so hot. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. She's so hot. Oh, I feel myself move inside. Oh my God. Oh yes, keep going. Oh, this is just like the day I saw her. Oh man, and her hair was like rain and her feet were like hail and her hands were like kisses and the bird on her shoulder was like my friend. Oh man, remind me, draw me to scale next to her, please. Please, someone. Please, don't forget. Oh yes, of course. She is gargantuan in the finest sense of the word. She is the definition of towering behemoth of a woman. Oh, she's so gorgeous. Oh man, oh wow. Oh, I am so horny. I am so fucking horny for her right now. Oh, and don't forget the epic brawl where I'm shooting all the men that are trying to come after her. Because she is mine, she's my lover, and I'm gonna protect her, damn it. Oh man, oh, this is great. I just came four times. Oh, this is so awesome. Thank you guys for reminding me what I look like and who my friend is and who my lover is. You guys are the best. Peace out.
This guy I dated for a pretty long time, actually. He'd invite me over, and every single time was the same. We'd watch TV, and then he would disappear for 4 hours to play guitar. And that was my evening for several months. Just like, first of all, you invited me over. And second of all, I'm living the same date over and over and over again for months. It's like I'm in 50 first dates. I'm in an Adam Sandler movie. I'm in an Adam Sandler. Oh my God, I'm Adam Sandler. I'm Adam Sandler. But I guess I fucking deserve to be Adam Sandler, because any guy who drops $400 on a guitar and then has you pay for his meals is clearly only with you because he hasn't figured out how to fuck his guitar yet. So after that utterly failed surprise, my next zebra was even sicklier, as rebounds often are. But Jesus Christ, do I have some good stories. I went on a date. I say like date because we were just supposed to be casually hanging out as friends. We went to this park, you know, we drove around, he found a parking spot, we were having a pleasant conversation, and then he just stops, and I'm like, hey, and he's like, I parked the car. Yeah, okay, cool, mm-hmm, yep, he's like, I parked the car. Yeah, okay, like, do you want a medal? Like, I don't, good job, you know how to drive? And he's like, I parked the car. That means that now you kiss me. The mental gymnastics you have to go through to make that make sense is just impressive. So I went out with him again the next week.
Oh, no.
And on that date, he, out of the blue, just goes, I'm a virgin, are you? And I'm like, no. And his eyes, like, light up, and he has the gall to be like, oh, so you can teach me. I think there's a really beautiful irony to not even looking for, but like expecting sexual experiences from an asexual. Once again, the mental gymnastics this guy could pull off were just like Olympics level. So this guy clearly had it in his head that I not only wanted to, but was planning on having sex with him, which didn't happen for obvious reasons. But anyway, this one time we're hanging out in his room and he gets like all serious all of a sudden, and he like sat me down. He was like, I've got to tell you something. And I'm like, oh shit, what now? And he's like, seeing how I see our relationship going in that direction, there's something you've got to know about me. And I'm so invested. I'm like, what? What is it? And he looks me in the eyes and he goes, so when I was born, I had some medical problems. And now I have one ball, like one testicle, and you can't tell anyone what it looks like. And I mean, that just stirs my imagination horribly, because if I'm not allowed to tell anyone what it looks like, what the fuck kind of monstrous, what's going on down there? Like, what am I not, I can't tell anyone? So it must be like crazy. So I did a lot of thinking and I settled on what it was, is like a tether ball, right? So it's like this, right? And I'm Jill. That's all I've got. You guys have been great. Thanks for having me.
Eden.
Why?
Because it says on the can, it's a delicious treat for anyone to eat. So eat it.
I don't like tomato soup.
You're going to like tomato soup, all right? The chef made it for you.
I don't want it.
Chef Boyardee.
I only eat clam chowder.
Watch your mouth. Clam chowder. Clam chowder. I like clam chowder.
That's not how I sound.
Yeah, it is how you...
That's not how I sound.
That was you.
Stop.
Maybe I'll stop if you eat your can of tomato soup. Whole.
Or what?
Or what? What do you think tomato soup's made out of, kid? Huh?
Tomato?
Tomato? Tomato soup's made out of kids, idiot.
I never thought of that before.
Because you don't ever think. So eat the soup and we won't have any problems, pal.
That doesn't make me want to eat it anymore. I thought tomato was like a vegetable.
It's actually a fruit, but...
That is very misleading.
Well, you know, what can I say? The chef, Boyardee, he does what he pleases. And that includes mistitling his soup cans.
Boy, that chef sure does work in mysterious ways.
Just like the tooth fairy. That's right, kid. That's right. Yeah. Okay. I lied. It wasn't kids. I just wanted you to eat your vegetables.
Chef Boyardee. Boy, this stuff is good.
Tell your doctor right away if your mood worsens, you have unusual changes in mood or behavior, or thoughts of suicide. Antidepressants can increase these in children, teens, and young adults.
Chef Boyardee.
Not approved for children under 18. People taking MAOIs or thioridazine or with uncontrolled glaucoma should not take...
Chef Boyardee.
Taking it with NSAIDs, aspirin, or blood thinners may increase bleeding risk. Severe liver problems, some fatal, were reported. Signs include abdominal pain and yellowing skin or eyes. Tell your doctor about all your medicines, including those for migraine. And while on...
Chef Boyardee.
Call right away if you have high fever, confusion, and stiff muscles, or serious allergic skin reactions like blisters, peeling rash, hives, or mouth sores to address possible life-threatening conditions. Talk about your alcohol use, liver disease, and before you reduce or stop Cymbalta. Dizziness or fainting may occur upon standing. Ask your doctor about...
Chef Boyardee.
Imagine you with less pain.
Chef Boyardee.
Can help. Go to
chefboyardee.com
to learn about a free trial offer.
Chef Boyardee. Boy, this stuff is good.
When I was moving to Chicago, everybody said, like, Chicago is so diverse. You're going to meet so many people. And I really thought my dating life was going to pick up. So I was so excited. But then I got there and all my encounters with men were either from the street or... a gay man in my theater department. So, got on Tinder, as one does. And I had my first Tinder date in the city, and I brought a Lunchable, and I wore a dress. we got tacos, and it was quiet and silent and awkward. And this man says, I wish I was a wizard. And I said, is there a follow-up to that? And I wish I could snap my fingers and this taco would be less spicy. Just was like, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think you're confusing picking the jalapenos off your taco for sorcery. Anyway, I deleted Tinder after that. Yeah. And then I'm back to Texas and I thought, let's get back on it. Wrong idea. Because I think that everyone here owns a gun, likes to fish, likes to take pictures with Bo. Who the fuck is Bo? But when I was getting back on Tinder, I got this ad for this Christian dating site called Upward, which is basically like Christian Mingle, but for poor people. And you know what? maybe I'll find myself a wholesome boy. So I threw that Bible verse in the bio. I think it was Hebrews 8:12. For I will forgive their wickedness and will remember their sins no more. Thank you, Jesus. I don't know what that means, but it's gonna work for me. Oh, so I got to swiping, and the first man I see is my brother. I did what was only necessary, and I deleted the app. And if you thought I was going to say I was going to swipe right, guys, remember, I'm from Texas, not Alabama. The closest I'll go, second cousins. And even then, most of them are friends with Bo, so that's a no-go. Back to Texas as a transfer. Hard to make friends, but then I made some really great ones, and they've been so inspiring and like really encouraging, and they're trying to get me to do Molly. They've been like, you go, girl, take that pill, woo! And something you should know about me is I'm afraid of drugs. So I looked up the side effects to Molly, which you should never do. And the first side effect to Molly was that it gives you a vicious sexual appetite. For me, that's pretty redundant. A cowboy if he's got a horse, or Santa if he sleeps with his elves, or Pete Davidson if he wants to smoke. He's already fucking high, and I'm already fucking horny.
Gentlemen, welcome to Fight Club. The first rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. The second rule of Fight Club is you do not talk about Fight Club. Third rule of Fight Club. If someone yells stop, goes limp, taps out, the fight is over. Fourth rule. Only two guys do a fight. Fifth rule. Only one fight at a time, fellas.
Is this Fight Club? Is this Fight Club?
Come again?
Fight Club.
One more time.
Fight Club. Right, I thought this was Fight Club, but is this Fight Club?
Shite Club.
Fight Club. Fight Club.
Shite Club.
Fight Club.
You're saying shite club?
Shite club.
Shite.
Yeah. I thought this is shite club.
So this is a fight club.
Fight what?
Fight club.
Fight what?
Fight. Why are you getting tripped up on club?
What?
Fight. Like fisticuffs. Like with your arms.
Oh, like fisticuffs, like fighting.
That's what I said.
So it's not. It's not psych.
No.
Well, I thought.
Okay, I'm gonna dissect your brain real quick. You came to an underground fighting arena to shit yourself.
Well, I don't know. I heard sight.
What are your intentions with a shite club?
I don't know. I thought this was a shite club. I think.
What?
Like the film, Shite Club.
The film Shite Club?
Yeah, with Brad Pitt and Brad Pitt and The guy that played the Hulk?
He's in Fight Club.
We must be thinking of different movies.
What movie are you watching?
Well, I haven't seen it, mate. I just heard about it. So this isn't Psych Club?
No. You look like a fool!
Alright, okay.
You were gonna shit yourself?
Cheerio.
The third time this week.
And now a presentation from the Lollipop Guild.
I love them so much.
That's
yes.
My son. Lights, please.
We represent the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, the Lollipop Guild, and in the name of the Lollipop Guild,
we want to welcome you to Munchkinland.
That was really good.
Can I go yet?
I told you, when the light is green, you go down.
It's just like, it's really tall.
Yeah, you walked up a lot of stairs to get here.
Mm-hmm, yeah. Are you sure it's clear?
The light's not green.
Why'd you look behind you?
The light's not green. I'm just looking at the light. Behind you is the line.
My first time here. I've never been on a water slide before.
And you chose the tallest one in the park.
I thought it would be cool. Like, that's what all the cool kids do.
Do you have friends? Because I noticed you went through this. You weren't talking to anybody in line.
Are you talking to someone else?
No.
We could be friends. We could talk.
Why would I be talking to someone else?
This is a new experience for me. Maybe we could just have a chat about like what it means to go down a water slide before I go down. Just so I know what I'm getting into.
This feels like a conversation real people don't have. Here's this, right? Have you ever been on a roller coaster?
Mm-mm.
When you were a kid, did you go to a park and go down a little slide?
You know, I don't know about that.
Do you have any idea what you're doing?
No. Mm-mm. No, I don't even know how I got up here, really.
Okay, this is flat stairs. No steppy, just down. Go down. This is what a slide is. You go down flat stairs.
Like behind me?
No, behind me. The green light that you're supposed to go through.
Okay, I'll do it. But
the light's not green.
Oh. What? Oh, I'm colorblind.
Great. I'll tell you when it's green, like I do for every other kid that goes through this line.
Okay, just tell me when. Can I go?
Sure. Go down the slide.
Okay.
Oh God. Oh, that's not gonna go well. Oh no. Oh no!
You kids didn't see that.
Looks like this is as far as this goes.
It's not far enough. Magneto should be on the floor below us.
Doesn't look like there's a way out of here. We're gonna have to find a way through.
Hey, new guy. Think you can swing this?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I got this. This looks like a job for Acid Cum Guy. Oh, yeah.
So I've been thinking about getting like a pair of those little fucking hanging dice, you know, for the thing on the X jet.
Do the claws hurt?
What?
Well, they like come out of your body. So
no, the claws don't hurt. What are you, some kind of?
Hey! Can you keep it down? Just please.
Mm, yeah,
just
sure.
A whole lot faster. Thanks. Thank you so much.
Sure, fucking thing, bud.
Sometimes it hurts. Some, not every time, but it's like kind of like.
Have you seen any good movies?
I'd rather just.
Totally. Don't even.
Hey. I need you to do something for me.
What?
Don't. Cut me. What? With your claws, man. Just cut me.
With my claws.
Come on. Okay.
Throw that bald fuck down a flight of stairs.
Come on. Oh, yeah!
Just come, you fucking ham!
Cigarette, can bomb or anything.
That's it!
Hey, look, if you wanted a lot of stuff, you should have called, like, acid piss guy.
We sat through 3 minutes of that for a tiny fucking hole?
Hey, look, I'm just working with what I've got, okay?
Well, you know what they say. If you want something done right, you gotta do it yourself. Yeah.
Fun Repellent does not protect against extended metaphors.
No problem. What about my asshole?
Okay, I'm recording.
I heard there was a squeak wolf for Alvin, Simon, Theodore. They're chipmunks and they go to human school. There they meet the three chipettes. There's Brittany, Eleanor, Jeanette. They think them chipmunk kids are so cool. Chipmunk ooh-yah. Chipmunk ooh-yah. Chipmunk ooh-yah. Chipmunk ooh-yah. The battle of bands was coming soon, but Alvin would rather play football. I thought you cared for music. Will do ya? Alvin flies, he lands, he wins, but his brothers, they ain't listening. They lost the battle all because of you. Alvin, you are. haven't you? Haven't you? Haven't you? The Chipettes are forced to play for Spears, but all they have to show are tears. Alvin was the one they wanted to, Theodore gets killed by a bird! The Chipettes scream for help and Alvin heard! They go home and then they fucking screw her! Hallelujah! 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 Hallelujah!
Here in Texas, residents are experiencing some of the worst winter weather of their lives. Two major storms hitting the state in the last 5 days, and another one on the way.
We also had portions in West Texas that were under a blizzard warning. We reported early this morning 7 degrees in parts of Dallas and other parts of the state. And right now we're looking at an evening that could get even colder.
I'm gonna go. Come on, come on, come on. Come on, please. Let's go.
We can't unlock this. I'll die. I'll fully die. Don't lock it. Don't lock it.